there. The COVID-19 vaccines have now become available in most countries. According to our world data, several countries have vaccinated nearly half of their populations. These COVID-19 vaccines have become the biggest and the boldest mass market product directed to the adult population globally. While the vaccination rate raises hope of getting to the end of this pandemic, the intriguing twists and turns in the pandemic narrative call for caution. We don't know where, when, and even how this story is going to end as it continues unfolding. I am Catherine Gaho from SBO Research. Thank you for tuning into my channel, Elevators, where we share elevating and empowering messages to lift you up. In this video, I will talk about the 5 stages consumers go through in making the decision to get COVID-19 vaccine. And I will share my own journey to that decision. I will review the process and the steps that individuals tend to go through before deciding to get vaccinated. The reason I have the biggest interest in this issue is that in my business, SBO Research, we conduct surveys on consumer adoption of new products for the health sector and other sectors. At the time when the treatment for malaria was changing to the current one, ACT, we were assigned to study the factors influencing adoption of the new malaria treatment among doctors, clinical officers, and patients. This is because acceptance of a new product comes down to people and their attitude and behavior. It's actually about consumer behavior. It's about adoption behavior, how human beings behave in assessing a new product and their willingness to accept it. Part of the assignment we did at that time was to test the effectiveness of communication materials that were being used by the Ministry of Health and the World Health Organization to help doctors and clinical officers and also patients to understand this new treatment. Now, this is because people seek to understand before they accept or participate in anything new. And that is not different at this time with the COVID-19 vaccines. Anyhow, in this video, I will attempt to answer the question, what stages does a consumer or an individual or family go through in deciding whether to take the vaccine or even which brand of vaccine to take? All these are consumer choice questions. There are a lot of lessons for us to learn about consumer behavior and attitudes in the uptake of these vaccines. The question of what brand to get depends a lot on what's available in your country. Here in Kenya, we now have AstraZeneca. We had Sputnik at some point, and now there is talk about the potential to bring Johnson & Johnson and also BioNTech. With millions getting the jab and over 1 billion consumers targeted in the world, these products are being talked about at every corner and every street in the world. There are real great lessons to learn on the stages in the consumer adoption process and the decision-making process for us students of consumer behavior. These COVID-19 vaccines are now the greatest mass market products in recent times. Furthermore, these vaccine brands have faced unique issues due to their complexity. And of course, these have complicated consumer understanding and decision-making. Some have faced great publicity issues also. And now there are questions centering on lack of availability or actually what some people are calling vaccine hoarding by some countries. Again, this vaccine phase in the COVID-19 pandemic narrative has introduced new vocabulary to the masses, to the consumers, where words like single dose, double dose, efficacy, you know, vaccine safety, side effects, and even blood clots and such complicated terms have become common terms in daily conversations. Globally, the COVID vaccine headlines have shifted from uptake to questions about the interval between vaccine doses, to questions about when more vaccines will become available, which are the next priority groups, as well as availability of the second dose And if you can mix different vaccine doses and the like. The other day, the Ministry of Health revised the interval between vaccine doses to 3 months. Previously, they had talked about 2 months. When people would go for the jab, they would get an SMS telling them when to go back for the next dose, which was within 2 months. I also read that Ontario in Canada has increased the time between the first and the second dose to 16 weeks. They've cited evidence indicating that efficacy will not be impacted negatively. This is also being done to ensure that more people get the first dose, since there are issues with vaccine supply and shortages. Actually, the whole business of the supply chain of these vaccines is appearing very complicated. Even the distribution within countries once the vaccine is available, it's not yet stable. Again, even as all this is going on, many people are still in the decision-making phase. In a previous video, I talked about the different adoption categories that we all belong to, showing the differences in the timings before different types of people decide to get the vaccine. The question of consumer decision-making is key in this phase of vaccine adoption because it's actually a decision by individuals. It's not compulsory, it's a decision someone has to make. Now, the acceptance of new products by users normally spreads through communication to members of the public over a period of time. The adoption process is the decision-making process that a person goes through from the point of becoming aware of the new product, say COVID-19 vaccines, to the point of accepting to get the jab. Research shows that those who accept to use new products tend to go through 5 definitive stages before they make the decision and go for the jab in this case. Now, to the 5 stages in the consumer decision to get the COVID-19 vaccine. And now also I'll share my journey to the decision to get the jab. Let me first say that I've gone through all these stages myself and I decided to get the vaccine a few weeks ago. Yes, I did get the first dose of AstraZeneca vaccine a few weeks ago. I will explain how I felt and the side effects I experienced at a later stage as we go through the journey. The 5 stages or the steps that people go through are first, knowledge or awareness. The first stage of the new product acceptance process is awareness, the point at which the target users become exposed to the new product for the first time. So when did you get to know about the COVID vaccines? What was the first time that you learned about them? Now, actually, the information about these COVID-19 vaccines started trickling down during the research phase. That's when I started hearing about it. And then after introduction, we started to hear more about it. In fact, there was a lot of fanfare when the first vaccine became available. And then now they've come to the distribution question. There's a lot of information and headlines about the distribution issues. And then now the vaccination stage. So in my journey, I came to learn about the vaccines through the media in the first instance. And I had great curiosity about this. And so I've kept searching for more information and more information. And that's why I keep talking to you, my viewers, about this issue of COVID-19 vaccines. Now, the job of manufacturers at this first stage is to provide information to help answer the questions that consumers are likely to be asking, that people are asking, and to communicate in a manner that gets user understanding. People want to know, how does it feel? What are the issues? How does it work? Does it cover what or what period and all that? There are so many questions about that vaccine in the first stage of awareness. The second stage is persuasion. In the second stage, the target users develop interest in the new product and form either favorable or unfavorable attitudes about the product. So they are persuaded to either think it's good or that it's bad. In the case of these COVID-19 vaccines, the manufacturer's role at this stage is to provide information to help persuade people about the benefits of vaccination. They need to communicate in a clear and credible manner. This is the stage where they should answer the questions on how it works, possible side effects, and so on. They need to share information that is personally relevant to different groups and their situations. In my journey in this stage, I took time to learn more about the vaccines. There was so much conflicting information, but eventually I weighed my options and started to see the value and the relevance for me personally. Because of the nature of work that I do and my interactions as an essential worker in the education sector and my interactions in the knowledge sector. The education sector was actually identified as one of the essential sectors in Kenya. And so education workers had access to the vaccine early. The third stage is decision, is the stage of decision making. This involves decision making based on evaluation of the information available. The people assess the information they have and draw conclusions whether to accept or reject the new product or vaccine in this case. Mind you, in the previous step, they already have kind of formed an attitude of favorability or unfavorability, and that will contribute to this stage. In the case of these COVID-19 vaccines, the role of the manufacturer at this stage is to facilitate decision-making and create confidence by providing more specific information on how the vaccines affect you, how they work, and by demonstrating how they work on the early users, the early adopters. In my journey at this stage, I personally made the decision that I will take the vaccine, and I proceeded to make a booking at my preferred vaccine center. At that time, demand had started increasing and there was the long Easter weekend, you know, coming in between. So I got an appointment to go on the sixth day. This was important for me as I had gathered all the relevant information, had analyzed it, and had interpreted the situation for myself personally. And I also realized that this is a decision that you have to make for yourself. Personally, it was important for me because of the need to interact in my work in the knowledge sector, the education and research sectors where I work most of the time. The fourth step is implementation, or, you know, the actual use stage. This is where you actually get to use it. Now you have the booking, now you go and actually do get the job. At this stage, consumers are willing to put the new product to use. Their experience with the product will provide them with the critical information to confirm that they were right in their decision-making stage. Now, in case of these COVID-19 vaccines, the role of the manufacturer at this stage is to get the user to take action and to use the product. And they do this by providing information to help reduce perceived risk. There are so many perceived risks around these vaccines. So you help people remove the fear. There's this thing of fear of injection and the like. In my journey, at this stage, my booked date and time came, and I actually went for the job. In my booking, I'd been allocated the 12 to 1 p.m. slot. I was coming from work to go for the vaccine. The job happened so fast that I just felt a quick prick. Actually, when I used to look at the pictures on TV of people being jabbed, the needle used to look longer. It used to look like it's going very deep, and I used to think it's a very, you know, painful jab. But when I did it, I just actually felt a quick prick, and as I was waiting for the pain to come, nothing else happened. It was that quick. I was then advised to go home and rest. The one side effect that I got was some tiredness for the next few days, but nothing serious as such. I could continue with work, just, you know, I just felt a bit tired and slow. The fifth stage in this process is confirmation. This is a final stage where you confirm. Following the usage, the consumers will seek reinforcement for their chosen decision. If they get positive feelings, they confirm the decision was right. And if they say it's right, they are likely to spread positive word of mouth to others. If the experience is negative, they are likely to spread negative word of mouth about it. In the case of these COVID-19 vaccines, there are those who say that they felt okay after vaccination, and others who say they had some fever or headache, and even fatigue or chills. And then some people talk about muscle pain and even the inability to function. Generally, the reported side effects have been mild and moderate for most people, and they last a short time. However, there are a few people who have said that they've experienced more serious side effects, and those are being documented at the Ministry of Health. They've actually created a committee to respond to this, to deal with this issue of side effects. We've had some people talk about heavy fatigue where they couldn't even get up, inability to function normally, blood clots. Those are things we've heard about on television and the like. But in reality, my personal experience was totally different. The role of the manufacturer at this stage is to keep providing information on what to expect and what to do about it, and to give people assurance. In my journey at this stage, my experience after the vaccine was positive, and so I share positive messages about it. That was how I went through the consumer decision process for COVID-19 vaccine. And these steps that I've talked about are actually general and apply to all manner of new products. So to sum up, the stages in the consumer decision process to get the COVID-19 vaccines are: one, knowledge or awareness. The second is persuasion or interest. The third is the decision. The fourth is implementation or action. And the fifth is confirmation. Thank you for staying with me for this time. Do like this video and share it with other people who you think might benefit from it. Thank you so much and best wishes. We all need to elevate our mindset at this time.